A mendicant told me, "You must keep awake at least one whole night this month. If you can do that, you will live. If you can't, you will die on the last night of the month." I thought it is easier. Perhaps death makes one sleepy. So I slept every night. Tonight is my last night. Tonight is my last chance, or tonight is the last night of the month, perhaps even of my life. I asked the mendicant what I had done to deserve this fate, and he said, "You have written plays, you have staged them and made the people sleep when they came to watch your plays. Tonight may be my last night. I have fled from home and come to this temple. I swear by this god, if I survive this night, I shall have nothing more to do with themes, plots or stories. I abjure all storytelling, all play acting."
"You know how Mysoli, the master of my house, is? This evening they ran short of kasbi oil and there was no peanut oil in the house. The bowl of castor oil was also empty. So they went to bed earlier and I was allowed to come here."
"How disgusting. Kasbi oil? Peanut oil? I always do with coconut oil."
"I don't believe it. They are naked lamp flames? No wicks, no lamps, no one holding them? Just lamp flames on their own, floating in the air? They are naked lamp flames. No wicks, no lamps, no one holding them? Just lamp flames on their own, floating in the air. Is that even possible?"
"Hello, what a pleasant surprise. You are here before us tonight?"
"I had heard that when lamps are put out in the village, flames gather in some remote place and spend the night together gossip. So this is where they gather."
"We have a new guest here. Hello, flame. Where are you from?"
"I am coming from a house. I have an old couple in my house. Tonight, the old woman just finished eating, swept, cleaned the floor and went to the room in which her husband was sleeping. And what should see but a young woman dressed in a brand new sari step out of the room. She ran out of the room and disappeared in night. The old woman woke her husband up and questioned him, but he said he knew nothing. There started the quarrel."
"But who was the young woman? How did she get in your house?"
"Let me explain. My mistress, the old woman, knows a story and a song, but she kept them to herself. She never told the story nor sung the song. Today afternoon, when the old woman was asleep, the story and the song jumped out through her mouth. The story took the form of a young woman and the song became a sari. She stepped out just as the old lady was coming out. Thus, the story and the song created a feud in the family and were revenged on the old woman."
"But where are they now, the poor things? How long will they run around in black? What will happen to them?"
"I saw them on my way here. Told them to follow me. Here comes the story with the song."
Welcome. We will listen to you.
Thank you, my dears. It is kind of you. But what is the point of you listening to a story? You can't pass it on.
That's true. What can we do? Wish we could help.
I will listen to you.
Who are you? Let me go.
Hey, I will listen to you. I will listen all night.
You will?
Yes.
But there is a condition. However, you must tell it again to someone else.
Sorry, it is not possible because I have just taken a vow not to have anything to do with plays.
Goodbye then. We must be going.
Wait, don't go please. I suppose I have no choice. So now you know why this play is being done. I have no choice. Bear with me, please. As you can see, it is a matter of life and death for me. Hey, musicians, come on. The story and the song.
This is the story of a young girl. Her name is Rani, which means queen. She is extremely beautiful. She is the queen of long tresses. When tied up in a knot, it resembles a black king cobra. She is the only daughter of her parents, and they found a husband for her. His name was Aparna.
Sita Kalyana Vaipogame Rama Kalyana Vaipogame Sita Kalyana Vaipogame
please. What are you thinking?
I want to go back to my parents. I want to see them. They are beyond the seventh sea.
Listen, I feel frightened alone at night.
What is there to be scared of? No one will bother you. Give me rice.
please.
Look, I don't like this idle chatter. Do as you are told. You understand? I'll be back tomorrow for lunch.
And so the days rolled by.
I want to see my parents.
Don't worry. Your parents are always with you. One day, a prince will come and he will make you happy forever.
Mother, you can't do this. That Appanna should have been born a wild beast or a reptile. By some mistake, he got a human birth. Why do you want to see him?
He is the son of my best friend and I want to see him right now. I heard you talking about Appanna still going to the concubine. I am a bit worried.
Nothing, mother. I saw a lady.
The same old story.
You don't believe. Yes, now you have reached Appanna's house. I think there is no one in the house.
How is that possible? His bride should be there at home.
Who can tell about Appanna? He is mad. Oh, that anthill. There is a big cobra in it. A king cobra.
Go up to the house and just look what you see.
All right, mother. The house is empty.
Of course it is silly.
Oh my God!
Stop! Stop! I tell you, I heard a noise. There is a woman inside the house. And the lock means... Appanna does not want anyone to talk to his wife.
Who is there?
What is your name?
They call me Rani.
And where is Appanna?
I don't know.
When did he go out?
After lunch yesterday.
When will he come back?
He'll be back for lunch later in the day.
So, you are alone and Appanna comes only for having lunch?
Yes. But dear mother, who are you?
Don't be afraid. I am called Kurudava because I am blind. Your mother-in-law and I were like sisters and Appanna is like a son to me. Does Appanna beat you or ill-treat you?
No.
Does he talk to you?
That he does. But only do this, do that, serve food.
You mean,
apart from him, you are the first person I am seeing since coming here. There is no one to talk to.
That is not what I meant by talk. Has your husband touched you? Oh God, how can I explain that to this girl? Dear girl, don't cry. Don't. Come. Let me touch you. My eyes are all in my fingers. Ayyo, how beautiful you are. Ears like hibiscus, skin like young mango leaves, lips like rolls of silk. How can that Appanna miss such loveliness?
I'm so frightened at night.
At home, I sleep between father and mother. But here alone, will you ask them to take me home?
Che, che, don't say that. I will take care of everything. Son, son, come here.
No, I won't.
Come here, you idiot. Go to our house. Get into the cattle shed.
Then?
In the left corner, there is an old trunk.
Old trunk?
Inside it, there is a wooden box. There are pieces of root in the box.
For what?
Bring them here now at once. Don't waste time. Run.
Who is that? What did you say?
He is my son, Kappanna. And he is my eyes. One day, a mendicant came to our house. I was alone there and I cooked hot food specially for him. He was pleased with me and gave me 3 pieces of root. Any man who eats one of these will marry you, he said. And then, one day, a boy came to live with us. I gave one of the roots to him, mixed with the meal. He finished the meal, gave me a look, and instantly fell in love with me. He married me within the next 2 days and never went back to his village. This is the root I was telling you about. Grind it into a nice paste and feed it to your husband. He will make you his wife instantly.
But I am his wife already.
Just do as I say.
Who is that? Gurudava? I don't want anyone here. Come on, leave now. I'm lunching out today. Just heat up a glass of milk for me. Milk?
I can't believe the lock is still there.
Who is that?
Me,
Gurudava.
What happened, child? Did you feed him the root?
Yes.
And what happened?
Nothing. He felt giddy and fainted. Then got up and left.
That's bad. This is no ordinary infatuation then. That concubine is obviously...
What?
Didn't want to tell you. There is a woman, a bazaar woman. She has your husband in her clutches. There is only one solution to this.
What?
Feed him the larger piece.
No.
Yes.
that blind woman and her son. Let them step here again and they will know. I will bathe and come to eat. Serve my food.
Shall I pour it then? Oh my God! What is this? Blood! Perhaps poison. It is dangerous. And that woman is blind. Suppose something happens to my husband? What will my fate be? No. Forgive me, God. Father, mother, forgive me. Now, I must get rid of this before he notices. Where can I pour it? Yes, that anthill.
Rani, see what is bothering the dog. Rani? Rani! Where have you been? I said, where have you been? Rani, answer me!
What a wild place is this?
Don't be frightened.
You know this place? It is full of snakes.
Don't say that. Hey look, a very big cobra is entering that house.
That is true, through the bathroom. Come on, let us run away from the place.
You?
Yes.
Food?
No. Why don't you sit? Are you so afraid of me? Then sit down.
No.
I will go and sit there away from you. Will you at least sit then? Now,
You are beautiful. Don't be afraid. Poor thing.
Poor thing?
That a tender bird like you should get such a rotten husband.
I didn't say anything.
I know. Did it hurt? The beating this morning?
No. I want to see my parents.
But are you not to give me a smile? A smile first? Oh, this dog creating problems. All this barking and howling.
But you brought the dog here only this morning?
Yes. I know. May I sit by you now?
Yes.
Don't be afraid. Tell me about your parents. Tell me everything. What a beautiful long hair. Like a dark black snake princess.
Hello friend, no intruders tonight, huh?
But when did you go away?
Yes?
Oh, nothing.
Good.
I must have been dreaming again.
What is this?
I must be going mad. I'm certainly not dreaming now. What is reality? I don't know.
It is not a dream. I'm here in front of you. Come on, touch me if you want. Talk to me. No? Then I had better go.
What do you want me to say?
Anything. Tell me about yourself, about your parents.
What can I say if you behave like this?
Like what?
You talk nicely at night, but during the day, I only have to open my mouth and you hiss like a stupid snake.
What should I do then? Stop coming at night or during day?
Who am I to tell you that? It's your house, your pleasure.
No. Let's see. The husband decides on the day visits and the wife decides on the night visits. So, if you don't want, I won't come at night.
Why do you tease me like this? I'm sick of being alone.
cheeks and your shoulders that looks like tooth marks.
Don't worry. It's okay.
Wait, let me apply ointment. I kept in the mirror box.
What is it? What is it, Rani?
When I looked in the mirror, I saw there where you were sitting. Instead of you, I saw her.
Don't worry. I'm here now. Nothing more to fear. Why are you crying? What is it now?
I said be quiet. I didn't know you were such a bad man. Had I known, I would never have agreed to marry you. What will father and mother say if they came to know?
They will say good. Our daughter is following nicely in her footsteps.
Don't say that.
Rani, this is life. Human nature is like that. The same happens in animal world also. The female begins to smell like wet earth, and stung by her smell, the king cobra starts searching for his queen. Everywhere they come together and fall apart. It is there and there and there, everywhere, everywhere.
You talk a lot in the night, but no word in the morning.
It is almost dawn. I must go.
No, no, don't go.
I will be back at night. I shall come home every day, twice, at night and at midday. At night, wait for me here in this room. When I come and go at night, don't go out of this room. Don't look out of the window. Whatever be the reason, and don't ask me why.
No, I won't. But can I ask for it again? Yes, I want it again. Appanna?
Mother, Appanna's dog is dead.
Is somebody inside the house?
Snake! Snake! A cobra!
Where?
In the backyard, out of the bathroom drain.
Who is it? Kurudava? Yes, it's me, child. Is Appanna there? Yes. Well, my child. Have you started your married life? Yes, Kurudava. The magic root. Your husband will always remain with you. Well, my work is done. I will be off now. Bless you, child. Please come again.
Hey, nothing. You don't believe me if I tell you. It was her again, Ogress.
When you talk like this, I feel we are falling apart.
Mother, just listen.
Shut up now.
What happened to the dog? It is dead. Something has bitten it. Perhaps that cobra from the anthill.
But last night, he has blood on his cheeks and shoulders. Now? The death of the dog infuriated Appanna. He next brought a mongoose. The mongoose lasted only one day, but it had evidently given a tougher fight. Its mouth was full of blood. There were bits of flesh under its claws. Bits of snake skin were found in its teeth. Rani fainted when she saw the dead mongoose. That night, he did not visit her. There was no sign of him the next 15 days. Rani spent her nights crying, wailing, pining for him. When he started coming again, his body was covered with wounds, which had only partially healed. She applied the ointments to the wounds, tended him, but she never questioned him about them. It was enough that he had returned. Needless to say, when her husband came during the day, there was no scars on him.
Is it?
Thank God.
Why?
All these days, I was never sure. I didn't just dream of these nightly visits of yours. Every night, I'm anxious, waiting for you. I couldn't distinguish between reality and fantasy. But thank God, that is all past now.
Why?
I have definite evidence to prove I was not fantasizing.
What evidence?
I am pregnant. Why are you looking at me like that? There is a baby in my womb. Doesn't make you happy? What am I going to do with you? Laugh? Cry? I thought you would dance with joy on hearing the news. You are not happy about the baby? You are not proud that I am going to be a mother? Sometimes you are so cold-blooded. You cannot be human.
I'm glad you hid the news from all this time. Even now, try to keep it from speaking about it as long as possible. Keep it a secret.
From whom?
From me.
What are you talking about? I have already told you. How can it be a secret again?
Yes, I realize. But please do as I tell you. Keep it.
Yes, I shall. Don't ask questions. No, I won't ask questions. Scowls in the day, embraces at night. But day or night, one motto does not change. Don't ask questions. I was a stupid, ignorant girl when you brought me here. But now, I am a woman, a wife, and I am going to be a mother. But still, don't ask questions. You don't want the child, do you? What shall I do? Shall I have an abortion? Or I can ask Gurudava's help?
It's almost morning. I must go.
What?
I have to go.
Go.
you ashamed to admit it, you harlot. I locked you in, and yet you managed to find a lover.
I swear to you, I haven't done anything wrong.
You haven't? You shame me in front of the whole village. You darken my face. I will show you. I will go to the village elders. And if they don't throw you and the child into boiling oil, my name is Nodapana.
Oh my god! A snake! A cobra! Humiliating me like this? Why don't you kill me instead? Why do you want me to stand before the village elders?
Rani, the village elders will sit in judgment. You will be summoned. That cannot be avoided.
What are you talking? Go and tell to the elders that my wife isn't a whore. After all, how could you complain to the elders about me?
I'm sorry, Rani. Listen, you do trust me, don't you?
Who else is there for me?
Then listen to me carefully. When you face the elders, tell them you will prove your innocence. Say you will undertake the snake ordeal.
Snake ordeal? What is that?
Look at that anthill. A king cobra lives in it. Say you will put your hand into the anthill.
What?
Yes, and pull out the king cobra and take your oath by that cobra.
I can't.
There is no other way.
Yes, there is. Kill me right here. Won't the cobra bite me the moment I touch it? I will die like your dog and mongoose.
No, it won't bite. Only you must tell the truth while you are holding the cobra. Say anything, but you must speak the truth.
And if I lie?
It will bite you.
Oh God!
All will be well, Rani. Don't worry. Your husband will become your slave tomorrow. You will get all you have ever wanted.
Wait. The night is almost over. Tomorrow won't be a day like any other day. I don't want any tomorrows or days after. I want this night to last forever.
We have done our best, but you refuse to listen to us.
This Appanna says that he hasn't touched the girl, but yet she is pregnant. He had registered the complaint, so we must judge it.
The traditional test in our village code has been to take the oath while holding the red hot iron in hand. Occasionally, the accused had chosen to plunge the hand in boiling oil, but you insist on swearing the king cobra. The news has spread. As you can see, it attracted large crowds.
Listen to us even now. If the cobra bites you, it will be dangerous for your child also.
We shall be condemned if we go through the ordeal of the red hot iron.
I'm young and immature. I know nothing. But I ask pardon of the elders. I must swear by the King Cobra.
All right, if you insist, come now, child. Truth shall prevail. Come.
Go on, child. Don't delay now.
I'm scared. Please, if the cobra bites me, what shall I do? I'm afraid. Please, please help me.
You whore!
Remember, child, you have a choice of audience, even now.
Yes, I shall take my oath, holding the red hot iron.
Kappanna! Kappanna! My son! Where are you? Can you hear me?
Gurudava?
Do you know that old woman? She has gone mad.
Her son disappeared a week ago.
Now she is always wandering around, calling him.
Kappanna! My son!
Help me, Gurudava. Help me, please.
My Kappanna is gone. That ogress! It is she! I must go. Look for my son.
Why should she suffer like this? Why should I let you push me around? Isn't it better to accept the kiss of the cobra and the dark silence of the anthill?
Come, child. The iron rod is hot and ready.
No. I want the ordeal by the cobra. Since coming to this village, I have held by this hand only two.
There! She admits it! Two, she says, two! Who are they?
My husband and...
And? Say it! Who else?
And this cobra. Yes, my husband and this King Cobra. Except for these two, I haven't touched any one of the male sex, nor have I allowed any other male to touch me. If I lie, let the cobra bite me.
Appanna, your wife is not an ordinary woman. She is a goddess incarnate. Don't grieve that you judge her wrongly and treated her badly. That is how goddesses reveal themselves to the world. You were the chosen instrument for revealing her divinity.
Spend the rest of your life in her service.
Bless us, mother. Bless our children.
Bless us, mother. Bless our children.
Bless us, mother. Bless our children.
Forgive me. I'm a sinner. I was blind.
So, Rani got everything she wished for, a devoted husband, a happy life. In due course, Rani gave birth to a beautiful child. a son. Rani lived happily ever after with her husband, child and servant. This is a nice story. Wonderful.
It can't be. I can't accept this ending. This story has too many loose ends. I need a proper ending. The story is not over. The ending lacks something. Of course, the cobra.
Yes. Then I would try the cobra.
Should I not take a look? I have given her everything. Her husband, her child, her home, even her maid. She must be happy. Rani, my queen, the fragrance of my nights, the blossom of my dreams. Now, in another man's arms, in another man's bed? No, I can't bear this. Someone must die. Why shouldn't I kill her? If I bury my teeth into her breast now, she will be mine, mine forever. No, I can't. I can't. My love has twitched from my lips. I can't kill her. Yes, this king cobra is now no better than a grass snake. I can never become a human. And Rani, she's always for a man. Look at the hair. They're like me. Reptilian, cold, low. They're right for me. I shall summon my magical powers for the last time. I can hide in them. In my sleep, it sounded like my mother calling me.
Who are you?
What is it?
My head. It feels so heavy. Please, can you give me a comb? Could you please?
Certainly.
Hey, cobra! Stay away!
Oh, it is dead.
Your long hair saved us, Rani.
Yes. But we are not important. Our son is the blossom of our family. He has been saved. He has been given gift of life by the cobra. As by a father.
So?
Hey, cobra. It has to be ritually cremated. You must do me a favor.
Certainly.
When we cremate the snake, the fire should be lit by our son. And every year on this day,
our son should perform the rituals to commemorate its death.
What do you mean? That's done only for one's own father. And I'm still alive.
Please, don't say no.
Of course. There is no objection because you are the goddess.
Is it really over?
These unhappy endings.
Why can't things end happily for a change?
But death, it is the only inescapable truth, you know.
Then why are you running away from it?
But that's how the story is. That's how it ends. I'm not to blame.
Stop making excuses. You are a playwright. You can change the endings.
All right, let me try.
What is it?
My head. It hurts. Can you give me a comb?
Hey, snake! Stay away! It's tiny, but this is a cobra. Thank God for your hair. We must kill it. Isn't there a stick anywhere here?
Hey, you! What are you doing here? He'll kill you. Go. Go away. No, not that way. He's there. Oh yes, that is the way. My hair. Come, quick, climb into it. Now stay there still. And lie still. Don't worry. It went that way, toward the bathroom. This hair is the symbol of my wedded bliss. Live in there happily forever.